The Canon EOS R becomes a different camera when paired with the Atomos Ninja V. Let's take a look at the 8-bit image versus the 10-bit image. To my eyes, the image quality does take an increase in quality, however, the jump in image quality isn't that drastic. You probably won't notice it that much, but I found that when exporting and delivering a 10-bit project, it yields a nicer and cleaner image, but there are some potential drawbacks when pairing the Canon EOS R with the Ninja V. In order to use the Ninja V, you'd most likely want to attach a cage so everything becomes more practical, especially when you have a shotgun mic on top of your body. This might bring on some more weight that you don't want and quite a few more parts to worry about. The fans on the Atomos Ninja V is definitely audible and will also contaminate your audio source. Anything other than a full-size HDMI can get finicky. I've had 3 to 4 different mini and micro HDMI cords because of failure. You have to be extra careful because the ports can be easily damaged when moving the cord around. The file sizes are also quite massive, so be prepared to buy more storage space if you plan on archiving all your footage. These are definitely some things that need to be considered and how they will affect your workflow. Aside from those drawbacks, the benefits are definitely there. You get monitoring functions that you don't get built in with most mirrorless and DSLR bodies, such as waveform, false color, vector scope, RGB parade, and a better LUT viewing experience. Judging exposure on a bigger monitor is much more feasible as well. Another thing to note is the file sizes are massive, but they are much more easier to edit on your computer. H.264 and H.265 files are incredibly taxing on your computer. If I could, I probably wouldn't want to have to bring a monitor around every time. I'd rather much have a body that can do it all or close to what a recorder can do because I prefer smaller setups where I can. I hope this helped in any way possible, and this is Narrative Gadget, and I'll see you next time.